哎，Krishna，咕噜队，您那边没有声音，没开麦。
Hare Krishna，can you hear me？
哦，好的，咕噜队，顶拜您的莲花座。
哦，顶拜你的莲花指。
Hare Krishna Maharaj。
Hare Krishna Guru Mani。
白坤的经，无人聆听。那奉献者，今天是2023年5月2日。
Om Magyana Timarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar, Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Are you okay, Guru Mani? You can hear me okay?
Yeah, the voice is very clear.
Okay. So we're hearing the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, we're hearing how Uttara, the mother of Maharaj Parikshit, wanted to hear the essence of what Maharaj Parikshit heard from Shukadeva Goswami.
嗯，Parikshit 的母亲 Uttara 想从 Parikshit 那里聆听他自己从他的 Guru Shukadev Goswami 那里聆听到的精华。
So Maharaj Parikshit is describing about how he was cursed to die in 7 days because of putting a snake around a great sage.
Parikshit Maharaj 就讲述说他自己遭到了诅咒，要在7天之内死去，因为他把一条蛇呢，死蛇戴在了一位伟大圣者的脖子上。
So Maharaj Parikshit is describing that after he was cursed, then Sukadeva Goswami appeared to him, and Sukadeva Goswami explained the truth of life.
Parikshit Maharaj 又继续形容说，当他自己遭到了诅咒之后， Shukadeva Goswami 就显现在他的面前，向他来讲述生命的真谛。
Yeah, and there was many great sages all came at the time of Shukadeva Goswami coming to speak Srimad Bhagavatam to Maharaj Parikshit. Many other sages also came to hear.
当舒克德戈斯瓦米来到 Parikshit Maharaj 面前给他讲述圣典博加瓦坛的时候，伟大的圣者们也纷纷到场来聆听。
And Maharaj Parikshit describes that when he heard from Sukadeva Goswami, then it took away any fear he had.
Parikshit Maharaj 继续形容说，当他聆听了 Sukadeva Goswami 讲述之后，这就拿走了他内心的恐惧感。
Not only was he not afraid, Maharaj Parikshit took great delight because he was given the association of so many wonderful devotees.
Parikshit 大君呢，不仅内心不再感到害怕，他反而感到很高兴，因为他现在得到了很多伟大圣者们的怜悯。
So Maharaj Parikshit tells his mother Uttara that in the same way I will help you to drink the nectar of the topics of Lord Krishna.
Parikshit 大君对他母亲说道，所以我要以同样的方式帮助您喝饮主 Krishna 话题的甘露。
So when Maharaj Parikshit was cursed, the many great sages came, people like Vyasa and Narada, they all came to witness the passing away of Maharaj Parikshit from the world.
当 Parikshit Maharaj 受到诅咒之后呢，像 Vyasadev和 Narada 这样的伟大圣人们就纷纷来到现场。来目睹 Parikshit 大君的光荣的离世。
Actually, in the beginning, there was some debate among the different sages about what Maharaj Parikshit should do.
事实上，在一开始的时候，这些圣人们当中呢，就有一场辩论，到底 Parikshit 大君现在该。采取什么行动？
Different sages had different explanations about what was the truth of life.
不同的圣人们对于生命的真谛有着不同的理解和解释。
And each sage who tried to establish their teaching was better than the other sages.
每一位圣人都想确立他的教导要比其他的圣人的教导要高明。
Some people would say Lord Hari is the Supreme Lord, but others would say Lord Shiva is the Supreme Lord.
有些人说主 Hari 是至尊主，还有另外一些人说主 Shiva 是至尊主。
And then some would say that the sun is actually the Supreme Lord.
The sun.
Yeah, the sun planet, the sunshine.
Oh, okay. 还有些圣人说太阳是至尊主。
And other people would say time is the supreme.
还有些人说时间是至尊的，至高无上的。
And somebody else would say man's nature is supreme.
还有些人争执说人类的本性是至尊的。
And some would say karma is supreme.
还有一些人的观点是 karma 是至尊的。
So what Sukadeva Goswami told Maharaj Parikshit was the most authoritative teaching. That was the highest teaching.
Sukadeva Goswami 对于 Parikshit 大君的教导是最权威的教导。
These teachings of Sukadeva Goswami were accepted by all the other sages as being the highest.
Sukadeva Goswami 的教导也被其他的圣人们接受为是最高的教导。
When Sukadeva Goswami appeared, then all the other sages, they stopped arguing with each other.
当 Sukadeva Goswami 显现之际，所有其他的圣人都纷纷停止了辩论。
Sukadeva Goswami, of course, he's the son of Srila Vyasadeva.
当然 ,Sukadeva Goswami 是 Srila Vyasadeva 的儿子。
And Lord Krishna had spoken to Maharaj Parikshit the main teaching of Srimad Bhagavatam through Sukadeva Goswami.
圣主 Krishna 透过了 Sukadeva Goswami 对 Parikshit 讲述了主要的教导。
So Sukadeva Goswami was enlightened, Maharaj Parikshit rather was enlightened in two ways.
因此 Parikshit 大君呢在两个方面得到了启迪。
Enlightened Maharaj Parikshit in two paths, two different ways.
Sorry. 所以 Sukadeva Goswami 就启发了 Parikshit 大君就有两条途径。
He was teaching the actual nature of the body and the soul. And in this way, he removed Parikshit's fear about death.
他教导了 Parikshit 大君关于生命的，生命的基本的本性，这就去除了 Parikshit 的恐惧心。
Yeah, he was because he knew he was going to be bitten by a snake. The snake bird was going to bite him. That would cause his death.
因为 Parikshit Maharaj 知道他将被一只蛇鸟，咬死。
So he has to worry about that, and he also has to worry about being in the cycle of birth and death.
所以 Parikshit Maharaj 呢就对此呢感到担心，与此同时呢，他还担心自己会再度卷入生死轮回当中。
But also Sukadeva Goswami brought Maharaj Parikshit a lot of joy, transcendental joy, because he was teaching him about devotional service to the Supreme Lord.
与此同时 ，Sukadeva Goswami 还给 Parikshit Maharaj 带来了超然的喜乐，因为他教导了他对至尊主的奉献服务。
So by the time Maharaj Parikshit spoke to his mother, his divine spiritual master Sukadeva Goswami had already gone away.
当 Parikshit Maharaj 对他母亲讲话之际，他的神圣的灵性导师 Sukadeva Goswami 已经离开了。
So it was actually time for Maharaj Parikshit to die, the time for his death had come. But Krishna arranged that Maharaj Parikshit's life would be prolonged.
实际上呢，就该到了 Parikshit Maharaj 离开躯体死亡的时候了。但是由于主 Krishna 的安排， Parikshit Maharaj 的寿命被延长了。
Lord Krishna arranged for Maharaj Parikshit to get the association of saintly Vaishnava, and that saintly Vaishnava was his mother.
圣主 Krishna 就安排 Parikshit Maharaj 得到神圣 Vaishnava 的联姻，而这位神圣 Vaishnava 就是他的母亲。
So Maharaj Parikshit says to his mother, he told her that, I want to serve you.I want to tell you all about the topics of Lord Krishna.
Parikshit 大君呢，就对他的母亲说：“我想服务您，告诉您有关于主 Krishna 的体旨。”
So to be able to hear the topics of Krishna in the company of Krishna's pure devotees is the most.The greatest achievement anyone could have in life.
在纯粹奉献者的联谊之中，聆听有关 Krishna 的体旨，是一个人生命当中有可能取得的最高的成就。
So Maharaj Parikshit says, he said, I bow down to Lord Krishna, the reservoir of causeless mercy.
Parikshit Maharaj 说道，我向圣主 Krishna 顶礼，他是无缘的仁慈的源头。
Maharaj Parikshit says also, I accept the appointed time of my death. I accept the curse of the Brahmana.
Parikshit Maharaj 说，我接受指定我的死亡的时间，我也接受婆罗门的诅咒。
And I know my time is actually up now. I'm actually meant to die now, but I'm taking advantage of this delay in my death to answer the question of my mother.
Parikshit Maharaj 说，我知道，我到了现在这个时刻，本来就应该到了死亡的时候了，但是我会利用这个我的死亡的延期来回答我母亲的问题。
I want to describe the essence of all the Vaishnava teachings.
我想要形容所有 Vaishnava 教导的核心。
So someone may question that, well, isn't Maharaj Parikshit just making a show of his own good qualities? Isn't he just being proud to speak about his own qualities?
有的人可能会质疑说，Parikshit Maharaj， 他是不是就有点对在炫耀他的好品质？他为自己的优秀品质感到骄傲了呢？
But Maharaj Parikshit wants people to understand that whatever good qualities he has, it is only due to the causeless mercy of Krishna.
Parikshit Maharaj 希望人们明白，无论他有什么样的好的品质，这都是由于主 Krishna 无缘的仁慈。
Krishna is the source of all mercy.
Krishna 是一切仁慈的源头。
Just like if we see a generous person, somebody is very generous, and they show a lot of kindness to a person who actually doesn't deserve any kindness.
就好比我们看到一位慷慨大度的人。他对一个根本不配得到仁慈的人展示了他的仁慈。
So, this is the causeless mercy of Krishna.
这是实际上呢是主 Krishna 的无缘的仁慈。
So Maharaj Pariksha says, even though I am most fallen and I'm most unworthy, I don't have any good qualities.
Parikshit Maharaj 说，虽然我最为堕落，也没有任何的好的品质，我不配得到仁慈。
But whatever good qualities have appeared in me, it's only due to the mercy of Krishna.
但是，无论我身上表现出什么样的好品质，都只是由于 Krishna 仁慈所导致的。
So whatever.Good things I speak about myself, we should know it's all the mercy of Krishna.
所以无论我谈到我自己身上的优点和一些好的事迹的时候，这都是由于 Krishna 的仁慈。
So this is supposed to be the end of Maharaj Pariksha's life. He's supposed to die at this point.But his life is being extended.
本来到了这一个时刻呢，本来 Parikshit Maharaj 他的生命应该结束了，但是他的生命被延长了，延期了。
Krishna is extending his life so that he has time to answer his mother's question.
主 Krishna 延长了 Parikshit Maharaj 的寿命。好让他可以回答自己母亲提出的问题。
Yeah, he's not even worrying about yoga meditation, about fixing his mind. He just wants to speak, to give the answer to his mother.
Parikshit 的大心呢，他现在并不在意瑜伽的冥想，或者是专注心意。他现在呢，就是一心的只想给自己的母亲回答他的问题。
So Maharaj Pariksit says to his mother, he said, I could satisfy you by telling you about the statements of the different scriptures scriptures like the Shrutis and the Smritis.
Parikshit 对他的母亲说道，我现在呢本来可以告诉你有关于经典的陈述，例如 Shruti 和 Smriti。
I could tell you about their actual meaning and what they imply.
我本来可以给您讲述他们这些经典的真正的意义，以及他们所包含的意义。
So this would be one way in which Maharaj Parikshit could answer his mother's inquiry.
这本来是Parikshit 大君可以回答他母亲询问的一种方法。
And if he did this, he would certainly have to distinguish which scriptural passages should be accepted and which should not.
如果他选择这种陈述方式的话，他就要去区分哪一段经典的论断是被接受的，而哪些经典的陈述是不能被接受的。
Yeah, sometimes, because sometimes the scriptures, you have to interpret them, and you have to try to figure out what is being meant.
因为有的时候呢，就有些的经典呢，你必须要去阐明他们到底他们所指的真正的含义是什么。
So Maharaj Parikshit said, I would prefer to, I prefer to satisfy you, to answer your question for you, by first relating a history, which I learned by the mercy of my spiritual master.
Parikshit 大君就对他的母亲说，我现在宁愿通过首先向你讲述一段我从我的灵性导师那里听到的故事来满足你。
Yeah, when you hear this story, when you hear this narration, which I'm going to tell you, that will get rid of all your doubts.
当你听到我给你讲的这段叙述的时候，你就会去除内心的疑惑。
So Srila Vyasadeva never actually initiated his son Sukadeva Goswami.
Srila Vyasadeva 实际上从来没有真正启迪过他自己的儿子 Sukadeva.
And Sukadeva Goswami never actually initiated Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 也实际上并没有真正的启迪了 Parikshit.
So the whole tradition of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam in the line of the cyclic succession depends on this relationship between Sukadeva Goswami and Maharaj Parikshit being guru and disciple.
所以整个的圣典博迦瓦坛的传统，透过使徒传系来聆听圣典博迦瓦坛的传统，就是依赖于 Sukadeva Goswami 和 Parikshit Maharaj 作为 guru 和门徒的关系。
So Maharaj Parikshit is going to tell us in his own words what he heard from his guru.
Parikshit Maharaj 将要以他自己的话来向我们讲述他从他的 guru 那里聆听到的。
And he's going to tell things in a very straightforward way.
他也将要以直接了当的方式来讲述。
He doesn't want his mother to have any doubt or confusion.
他不希望自己的母亲内心还有任何的怀疑以及困惑。
So Maharaj Parikshit begins to tell the story. He says that long ago, in the city of Pragjyotisha, there lived a very poor Brahmana.
Parikshit Maharaj 开始讲述这个故事，他说到，在很久以前，在 Pragjyotisha 这个地方居住着一位贫穷的婆罗门。
And this Brahmana was ignorant of the teachings of scriptures.
而这位 Brahmana 对于经典的教导是愚昧的。
And he always thought about getting money, about becoming rich.
他总是想着怎样得到钱财，从而变得富有。
Every day he would very faithfully worship the goddess of that particular place.
每天，这位婆罗门都会信心满满地崇拜当地的女神。
That the goddess of that place was called Kamakya.
这个当地的女神的名字就叫 Kamakya.
So, when that goddess was satisfied, then that Brahmana received from her in a dream a 10-syllable mantra.
当女神感到对婆罗门感到满意之后，这位婆罗门就在梦中从女神那里得到了一首十个音节的 mantra.
And that mantra was for worshipping the lotus feet of Madana Gopal.
这十个音节的 mantra 是为了就是要来崇拜 Madana Gopal 的莲花指。
And the goddess also taught the Brahmana how to meditate on the mantra.
女神也告诉 Brahmana 该如何冥想这首 mantra。
And how to do different practices.
以及怎样去做各种不同的修炼。
So that mantra appeared before him like a treasure, and it opened right before his eyes.
这首 mantra对他来而言就像一个宝藏，启亮了他的双眼。
So this Brahmana lived in northeast of India. The area nowadays is called Assam.
这位婆罗门居住在印度的东北部，现今名叫阿桑的地方。
And that city.Pragjyotisha, that was actually the capital of a kingdom of a demon called Bomasura.
And Pragjyotisha, 实际上是这 Bomasura 恶魔的王国的首都。
This is during the time of Lord Krishna.
And Bomasura 是主 Krishna 时代的恶魔。
So the Brahmana had never studied scriptures properly.
这婆罗门从来没有很好的、恰当的去研习经典。
And he never heard any explanation about the message, about the actual message from the teachers, from the authorized acharyas.
他也从来没有从权威的 acharya 那里。聆听到这些真正信息的解释。
So he was actually a very unfortunate, foolish person.
事实上，这位婆罗门实际上是非常不幸的愚蠢之人。
An actual educated person would not associate such a foolish person.
一位真正的受过教育的人是绝对不会和这样的愚蠢之人联谊的。
So this unfortunate foolish person actually shows the proof of the mantra, the power of the mantra that he received, because he was able to achieve all of his ambitions.
所以这位不幸的愚蠢之人，他的经历就展示了这首 mantra 的力量，因为这首 mantra 使他达到了，使他能够实现他的野心。
So he was given the 10-syllable Gopal mantra, which is described in the book. There's a book called Krama Dipika, which is all about Vaishnava tantras.
这首十个音节的 Gopal mantra 就在 一本名叫 Krama Dipika 的书当中描述了。Krama Dipika 这本书描述了 Vaishnava 的 mantra。
So these kind of mantras, Vedic mantras and Tantric mantras, they can only be chanted by qualified people.
而这些伟大的 mantra 和 mantra 只能是有资格的人所吟诵的。
And they have to receive these mantras through proper initiation.
而且是应该通过恰当的启迪来接受这些 mantra。
So when any scripture talks about these mantras, they will try to distinguish the exact syllables of the mantra.
当经典描述这些 mantra 的时候，他们会。非常清晰的
No, they will try to disguise the exact symbol. They won't want people to know the exact symbols of the mantra.
嗯，sorry, Mark.
They will disguise the actual. Yeah, they will disguise the words of the mantra, the syllables of the mantra.
Okay. 所以当经典他们在提及这些 mantra 的时候呢，他们实际上会在讲述这些 mantra 的这个字形成的这个音节和词语的时候呢，他们实际上会做一些隐藏。
Sometimes they will change the order of the syllables, so put them in different order.
有的时候呢，他这个书会刻意的来改变这些词语或者是这些音节的顺序。
And sometimes when they explain the mantra, they'll make it impossible to understand.
有时候当他们解释这些 mantra 的时候呢，会让人们不可能去理解。
So this book, this Krama Dipika, it describes the mantra, the 10-syllable mantra.
这部 Krama Dipika 描述了这首十个音节的 mantra.
It says, the holder of the bow, Saranga.
The holder, the person who's holding the bow. Okay, 所以他就说到，这个持弓者。
And the upper teeth.
以及上齿。
Teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah, just, huh?And then the sun god Surya.
还有太阳神 Surya.
And the second letter.
以及第二个字母。
Which joins the second letter joins with the goddess Vanakshi.
以及加入。Vanakshi 女神的第二个字母。
and the bearer of the trident.
以及三叉戟的手持三叉戟的人。
And Suri and Bala.
Suri, Bala.
And twice the younger brothers of Bala.
以及 Bala 的比 Bala 小一半岁数的他的弟弟。
And four more syllables.
以及再加上四个音节。
So the deity worshipped by this mantra is Madangopal.
这首 mantra 描述的神像就是 Madanagopal.
And the Madanagopal, that's the actual deity of Sanatana Goswami, who wrote this book.
Madanagopal 就是这本书的作者 Sanatana Goswami 的神像。
So Kamakya Devi, the goddess who's worshipped by this mantra, she gave the Brahmana not only the mantra, but she also gave him the method for meditating on the mantra's deity.
So Kamakya, sorry, can you repeat?
Yeah, she gave the Brahmana the mantra for meditating on the mantra's deity.
Oh, Kamakya 就给予这位婆罗门该如何冥想这首 mantra 的方法。
And she also told him how to touch one's body to purify it with the syllables of the mantra.
他也教会了这位，教导这位婆罗门该如何用这首 mantra 的音节来触碰身体的不同部位。
And also how to do different hand gestures to worship the deity.
以及该如何通过不同的手势，打不同的手势来崇拜神像。
So this Brahmana's attention was so attracted, it was carried away from the worship of, the goddess. He was so attracted by the Gopal mantra that he forgot his own religious activities.
这位婆罗门的注意力是如此的，就是被这首 mantra 所吸引，以至于他忘记了女神，也忘记了他自己的宗教职责。
Yeah. And the goddess ordered him, and he chanted the mantra constantly to himself in a secluded place.
这女神就命令这婆罗门，自己一个人恒常的在僻静的地方唱诵这首 mantra。
And the result of chanting the mantra is that he gave up his desire for wealth, and his heart became satisfied.
唱诵这首 mantra 的结果就是，这位婆罗门都放弃了想要获得财富的愿望，而且他们感到很满足了。
So this Brahmana was so stupid that initially, in the beginning, he ignored the advice of the goddess, and he didn't chant the mantra.He thought the mantra was just a dream.
这位婆罗门是如此的愚蠢，以至于他一开始就忽略了女神的建议，没有念诵这首 mantra， 他以为这只是一场梦而已。
But the goddess appeared to him a second time, a second dream, to give the instructions again.
女神呢，就第二次出现在他的第二次梦里头，再次给予他训示。
So he thought, there must be something other than this mantra. Something, he thought there must be something in the next life.
He just thought, Sorry, Mara, what does that mean?
He thought that there must be something more than the mantra. There will be something which will come in the next life, which will give him success and give him all his desires.
这位婆罗门就想，就是除了这首 mantra 之外呢，就是在他的来世，他一定会得到一些其他的事物，使他的生命成功，使他能够如愿以偿。
He was not able to understand the value of the mantra.
他当时不能明白这首 mantra 的价值所在。
He didn't know what to accept and what to give up.
他不知道该接受什么，该放弃什么。
But by the power of the mantra, his mind began to turn.
但是藉着这首 mantra 的力量，他的心意转变了。
He didn't think anymore about the next life. Previously, he was not interested in the next life.
以前呢，他对于来生也不感兴趣。
So that goddess, the goddess who had been instructing him, she did not give him the knowledge about the full power of the mantra.
给予这个婆罗门训示的女神，并没有揭示这首 mantra 的全部的知识。
So the Brahmana began to imagine other things, other means, other goals, material goals.
这位婆罗门呢，便开始设想着其他的物质的目标。
But actually, this Gopal mantra, even if one doesn't have knowledge, you can get a great benefit from it.
事实上，即便对这首 Gopal mantra 没有知识，一个人也可以。通过这首 mantra 得到巨大的好处。
Even if you chant the mantra without faith or understanding, you can get great benefit.
即便是对这首 mantra 没有信心，也不理解这首 mantra, 但是也能通过这首 mantra 得到巨大的好处。
So this Brahmana left his home.And he left, gave up all his connections, and he began to wander to holy places of pilgrimage.
This Brahmana 便离开了家，他抛弃了所有的跟他有关系的一切，他开始在圣地漫游。
And he would just live by begging.
他只是靠乞讨为生。
And he traveled to the places where the Ganga meets the ocean.
他来到了，他在旅途当中，他来到了一处恒河，汇入海洋的地方。
So because the Brahmana was chanting the mantra, the mantra gradually increased its effect.
由于这位 Brahmana 唱诵着这首 mantra, 于是这首 mantra 对他的影响便逐渐的增加了。
And he gave up his sinful activities, and he gave up all sense gratification, and he took to a renounced life.
他放弃了一切罪恶的活动，也放弃了感官享乐，他开始就进入了弃绝的生活。
So he came to the banks of the Ganges, and he saw there were many Brahmanas, who were mostly family men. And they were all expert in different kinds of knowledge.
他来到了恒河岸边，在那里有许多居士婆罗门，这些婆罗门擅长于不同的知识。
All of these men were devoted to performing their different duties.
所有这些人，他们都是忠心耿耿的在履行着自己的职责。
So, from the description we get that it's a place where the Ganges flows in the ocean. This means it's a place called Ganga Sagar, which is in Bengal.
从这段形容当中，我们知道，就是恒河入海处被称为是 Ganga Sagar， 它就是就在孟加拉境内。
So these Bengali people, they were all expert in the 14 Vedas, 14 departments of Vedic knowledge.
这些孟加拉人全都擅长于伟达知识的十四个部门。
Right, the four Vedas, and then the six supplements.
这包括四部伟达经。以及六部补充文献。
And then the Puranas and the Dharma Shastras.
还有 Purana 往事书以及 Dharma Shastra.
And the Mimamsa interpretation of the Vedas.
以及 Mimamsa 对于伟达知识的解释。
And then there's also an elaborate science of logic, Nyaya.
以及逻辑 Nyaya 科学的详细的 Nyaya 逻辑科学。
So these are the 14 departments of learning.
这便是知识的十四个分支。
So he heard these Brahmana Bengalis describe about the different duties which are there one is obliged to do.
这婆罗门便听到这些孟加拉的婆罗门在形容人们需要履行的义务和职责。
Yeah, there's two kinds. There's the regular duty, things you have to do regularly every day, and then you get some special things, occasional, not all the time, but sometimes they come up. You have to do something like maybe a birthday or maybe a death or a birthceremony.
这些职责呢，包括两部分，一部分是规范的职责，就是每天要从事的，还有另外一部分呢是特定的职责，比如说在人的出生和死亡的时候要举行的仪式。
It may be also duties done for achieving a particular material desire.
还有一个人为取得特定的物质，实现特定的物质愿望， 要从事的职责。
Like going to heaven.
比如说想要去天堂的愿望。
So when a Brahmin's initiated into Vedic rituals, they're expected to perform these different duties regularly.
So, 当一位婆罗门，他就期待他要从事有规律的从事这些伟大的仪式。
They're meant to do some kind of sacrifice, like.Agnihotri Yagna.
他们应当从事一些献祭，例如 Agnihotri Yagna 火祭。
Should be done twice every day at sunrise and at sunset.
这应该是一天从事两次，在日出和日落的时候。
And they may also be obliged to do other rituals.Special circumstances.
他们还要在特殊的情况之下从事一些必要的仪式。
Just like they do the Shraddha ceremony on the anniversary of the death of one of the elders.
例如在一个在自己的长辈的忌日祭典的日子。做刷的仪式。
So Brahmana may also do other kinds of sacrifices and make other kinds of vows also.
Brahmana, 他们理应还要从事其他的一些祭祀，或者以及去实现他们立下的誓言。
He wants to get some personal, he has some personal ambition, so he does some sacrifice to help him achieve that ambition.
他可能有一些个人的志向要实现，所以他要做一些其他的祭祀来实现。
So there's three kinds of duties for Vedic Brahmanas.
对于一个伟大文化的婆罗门，他有三类职责。
So the Brahmana who had come from Pragjyotisha, he must have heard all these Bengali Brahmanas at Gangasada.
这位来自 Pragjyotisha 的婆罗门一定是听到了这些在 Gangasada 的孟加拉婆罗门听到他们说话。
And he heard about how these Bengali Brahmanas glorified all the principles of Dharma.
He heard about these Bengali Brahmanas glorifying all the principles of Dharma.
So the scriptures say Dharma is to proper behavior.
经典声称 Dharma 是一个人的恰当的行为举止。
And the Lord of Dharma is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
而 Dharma 的主人就是至尊性格神首。
If a person has good behavior, then he has conquered both this world and the next world.
倘若一个人有良好的行为举止，他便在这个世，在这一生，所向披靡，而且在来生也所向披靡。
These Bengali Brahmanas, they would say that heaven is the fruit of all dharma, all religion.
这些孟加拉的婆罗门。还声称说天堂便是 Dharma 的结果。
It's described in the scriptures that the happiness of the residents of heaven is never given up by my misery.
The
happiness of heaven is never finished. It's unlimited. There's no misery there.
Okay. 经典还说天堂居民的快乐是永不结束的，他们那里是没有苦难的。
Yeah, one who goes to heaven, the happiness comes to them, just as they desire it.
对于一个去了天堂的人，快乐就如他所愿的会来到他的身上。
So he heard the Brahmanas, he heard the Bengali Brahmanas speak, and the other Brahmana from the other place, he could understand how determined they were in their duties, to perform their duty.
当这位婆罗门听到了孟加拉婆罗门和来自其他地方的婆罗门说的这一席话，他就明白到这些婆罗门他们是下定了决心一定要履行自己的职责。
So this Brahmana who had come from the other place, he was very impressed and he began to follow their process. He began to do everything according to their instructions.
来自别的地方的这些婆罗门于是便留下了深刻的印象，他也按照他们的方法也是按照他们的训示去做。
He had heard the Bengali Brahmanas that they were describing about the glory of Dharma in theory, and they were also acting the same way.
他听到这些婆罗门，荣耀不仅仅他们亲口的荣耀了 Dharma， 而且在理论上荣耀了，而且他们也亲身的实践了。
And he heard the Brahmanas make their vows and perform their duties like bathing in the Ganga every day.
他听到这些婆罗门，立下誓言。而且呢，每天的尽职尽责的在河中沐浴。
So he heard the Brahmanas make their vows, and he saw them do everything according. He saw them keep their vows.
他亲眼见证了这些婆罗门立下誓言，并且每一天也去实践这些誓言。
So this Brahmana who had come from the other place, he had never got any spiritual education.
来自其他别的地方的这位婆罗门从来没有受到过灵性的教育。
So these Brahmanas, the Bengalis, they began to teach him the principles of Dharma according to their understanding.
所以当地的就孟加拉的这些婆罗门于是便教导了来自其他地方的这位婆罗门有关于 Dharma 的原则，他们是按照自己的理解来教导他的。
So out of, because the goddess, that goddess had appeared in his dream and instructed him to chant the mantra, so he continued to chant that mantra quietly. He chanted the mantra to the goddess very quietly, he didn't tell anyone.
由于之前女神曾经在他梦中显现，教导了他这首 mantra， 这位婆罗门呢，他于是便静静的继续念诵了这首 mantra。
So by the influence of the mantra, he didn't feel any satisfaction from the rituals he'd been doing with the Bengalis.
由于这首 mantra 的影响，这位婆罗门对于他和孟加拉婆罗门一起从事举行的这些仪式，并没有感到满足。
Because he was worshipping the Supreme Lord, so he couldn't be attracted to anything less, lower than the Supreme Lord.
因为他在崇拜着至尊主，所以他不会被低于至尊主的，比至尊主的层级要低的其他的事物所吸引。
So after some time, he lost interest in all the rituals they were doing. And he left and went to Kasi Benares.
过了一段时间，他便对于所从事的所有这些仪式活动失去了兴趣。他就去了 Kasi, 贝纳勒斯。
And there he saw there were many different sannyasis from different places, and they were all teaching their theory of monism.
在那里呢，他见到了有来自不同地方的 sannyasi， 这些 sannyasi 在教导一元论的理论。
Okay, so we'll stop here today.
好，那今天我们讲到这里。
So we'll ask if there's any questions.
看到一个问题，舒提如何对 Darcy？ 明白，亲爱的 Gurudev 和大家，请问 Parikshit 王为母亲讲述 Krishna 之觉是介于对躯体的亲情，还是对灵魂的怜悯？我们应该如何向自己的无神论母亲和亲人传播 Krishna 之觉呢？是坚持做好自己的同时，把普沙等和奉献者的品质展示给他们，容忍他们的不理解，还是退而求次，以他们喜欢的方式照顾他们？感恩。Shruti Rupa de Das is asking, Pariksha Maharaj spoke Krishna consciousness to his mother. Is it due to the bodily affection or due to the compassion to the soul?
Well, his mother was a great devotee.
Parikshit 王的母亲是伟大的奉献者。
His mother, remember, had prayed to Lord Krishna to protect the child in her womb.
他的母亲曾经向主 Krishna 祈祷，请求主 Krishna 祈祷，保护他子宫当中的胎儿。
Ashwatthama had thrown the Brahmastra weapon, wanted to kill the child, but Uttara turned to Krishna and surrendered to Krishna.
Ashwatthama 发射出反射光，想要杀死腹中的胎儿。Uttara 便转向了主 Krishna， 臣服了 Krishna。
So his mother had been, she said, you see, I don't care about my own self, I can die, but don't let my child die.
他的母亲就对 Krishna 祈祷说，我不在乎我自己是否性命怎么样，但是千万一定要保护我的孩子。
Yeah.So we have to understand that his affection for his mother was not just based on the bodily relationship.
所以我们当明白 Parikshit 王对于他母亲的爱并不是基于身体。
But she had approached him, inquiring from him, submissively.Humbly, she wanted to know the essence of what he had learned from Sukadeva Goswami.
但是 Uttara 呢就主动的接近了自己的儿子，非常谦卑的一种顺服的态度接近他，想要理解，想要去明白他从自己的灵性导师那里得到的教导的精华。Shuti Rupa Devdas is asking, how can we spread Krishna consciousness to our atheist mother and relatives? Is that we we continue to do our service well and to show the quality of devotee to them and to provide prasadam to them?
Yes, you can try, but it's very difficult to convince your family elders, because they're senior to you and they simply know you as their child.
是的，你可以去尝试，但是要改变自己的家庭的长辈很难，因为他们都是比你年长，他们只是把你看作他们的孩子。
So they're not really submissive to you. They don't really want to hear from you.
所以他们并不是真正的就臣服你，想要听你的话。
Yes.
The next question is from Annie. 顶拜咕噜，顶拜您，请问咕噜，当普通人受到疾病的威胁和想象因疾病而痛苦的死亡时的恐惧时，应该怎么做才能让自己摆脱以上的负能量呢？咕噜。
Yes.
Yeah, she's asking, Guru, when the ordinary people, they are threatened by the disease and the imagination that they will die from disease and feel very painful, and they are fearful from that. So what should they do to get rid of those negative energy?
They should practice chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
他们应该练习去唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
They should cultivate spiritual knowledge to get detached from the material body.
他们应当培养灵性的知识，好不依附物质躯体。
Yes, it's expected we will be fearful at the time of death.
是的，就像您所说的，我们在就是对于死亡有这个恐惧感，这个是人之常情。
So you have to get association. People, just like Ajamila, he was an old man and he was going to die. The Yamadutas came, but he was saved because his son was called Narayan.
就像 Ajamila, 他是老人了，他马上就要死了，然后亚马杜特来抓他，但是他却被拯救了。由于他的儿子名字叫 Narayan。
So he he left home and he went to a temple and he went to stay in a Vishnu temple and he stayed there and did service and then he was able to leave the body.
Ajamila, 他就离开了家，去了一所 Vishnu 的庙宇，就在那所庙宇里做服务，直到他离开躯体。
So he took shelter of Lord Vishnu, took shelter of the deity, and they protected him from fear.
所以他就托庇于 Vishnu, 托庇 Vishnu 的神像，这 Vishnu 的神像就保护了他，使他不再感到恐惧了。
So in the same way, we have to cultivate attachment for Krishna.By chanting his holy name, then we won't be afraid at the time of death.
同样的，我们当培养，依附于 Krishna, 唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，这样在死亡的时候就没有恐，不再有恐惧了。The next one.
Yeah.
下一个问题来自于 Yuvati Sachi Devadasi. Hare Krishna, dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances, O Lord Guru Srila Prabhupada. First, I often hear the opinion that Kanishtha is a high level for us, and most devotees are not even Kanishtha. Is this true?
Yes.
他的问题 ，And who are we then? And who are we then? And at what level are we? 他有阿迪萨奇的第一个问题是，我经常听到这样的观点，说卡尼什塔初级奉献者，初级也是很高的层面，我们。大部分的奉献者甚至还没有到达初级的层面，是真的吗？那么我们到底是在哪个层面？我们到底是什么呢
？Well, it will depend on each devotee, what how you practice.
嗯，玛雅说是的，我们甚至还没有到达初级的层面。那至于我们到底是哪个层面，这要取决于每个奉献者的不同情况，根据每个奉献者的各自的修习。
So Kanishtha, he understands God in the temple, and he worships the deity with great faith.
Kanishtha 就是初级奉献者。他们已经明白了神庙里的神像，而且他们特别有信心的崇拜着神像。
So we, it depends on if we are going to see the deity regularly and worshiping the deity, then that's very good.
如果我们能够有规律的崇拜神像，那是非常好的一件事儿。
But do we see Krishna? Do we see Krishna in that? Do we see the deity as Krishna, or do we just see the deity as a statue?
但是我们有没有真正的看到神像就是 Krishna 本人呢？还是把神像看成一尊雕像。
If we just see Krishna as a statue, then we're foolish people.
如果我们把神像看成就是仅仅是雕像的话，那我们就是非常愚蠢的。
So maybe we're not yet Kanishtha Adhikari, but we're lacking faith. We have to have more time to come to the Kanishtha platform.
就是我们还没有到达 Kanishtha 的层面的话，那就说明我们缺乏信心，我们还要更多的时间才能来到 Kanishtha 的层面上。The next one，下一个吗？What is the reason for the name of the cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam? For example, the first canto is called creation, but the creation is told in the second and third canto. 就圣典博伽瓦坛各个每一篇命名是背后的理由是什么？例如第一篇被称为创造，但是创造也在第二篇和第三篇当中被讲述了。
Yes, well, there are 10 topics in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
圣典博伽瓦坛有十个主题。
Yeah, the first canto is called creation, but creation is also described in the second and third canto. You're right.
是的，您说的很正确。第一篇的主题是创造，但是在第二篇和第三篇当中也讲述了创造。
We have to understand that there are 10 topics in the Srimad Bhagavatam. They're mentioned. If you go to chapter 10 of the second canto, the first verse of chapter 10, second canto, you'll see the 10 topics are listed there.
如果是你要是看圣典博伽瓦坛第二篇第十章世界一的话，就会发现这个世界当中叙述了圣典博伽瓦坛的十个主题。
So these titles are given for each canto. It doesn't mean that.Creation is only described there. Other topics are also discussed.
而且呢，就是他们的每一篇有这些主题，每一篇他们有各自的名字，并不意味着，就只是在这一篇当中讲述了这个主题，在其他的篇。圣典博伽瓦坛的篇章当中也讲述也能够讲述这些主题。
Just like the 10th canto is called the summum bonum, meaning that the perfection, the goal of everything. And that is the 10th canto is all about Krishna.
第十篇的标题是至善，它也也就是说指的是目标或者是完美境界，它就讲述了 Krishna。
And the 9th canto is called Mukti, Liberation.
第九篇叫 Mukti, 解脱。
So these titles are given for us to help us to appreciate that there are 10 topics mentioned there in Srimad Bhagavatam.
这些每一篇的名字告诉我们，这些名字就是为了让我们帮助我们欣赏圣典博伽瓦坛讲述了十大主题。
OK
下一个问题是来自于君伟，明白这样的孤队我翻译，谢谢。图拉西镜珠可以戴在手腕上吗？昨天我戴了手脖子上，女儿看到很喜欢，向我要。 但是他在吃肉，可以带普拉西的净珠吗？难不得。
Well, people who eat meat, we don't give them tulsi. But if they want to buy it themselves, that's they're doing it. But it's not good that people who are wearing tulsi are eating meat. We don't encourage it, but we can't stop it. We can't stop people from purchasing things.
就是那些，我们不会，把 tulsi 给那些食肉的人，但是如果他们自己买，那就另当别论了。但是，这些食肉的人带着 tulsi 呢是不好的，我们并不鼓励这种做法，但是我们没办法阻止他们。
And what was the first part?
First is that, can we wear the tulsi beads on, kantimala on our wrist?
On your wrist.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, you can do. Usually we wear them around the neck.
Can you do it?但是一般来说我们是戴在颈部的。
You wear them on your wrist. You have to be careful. You want to keep them clean. You want to protect them. I don't know if you put them on your wrist. I don't know if you can be sure to keep them clean.
那您戴在手腕子上，您要小心，确保它们清洁，保护它们的清洁。不知道，我不能肯定你戴在手腕子上是不是能确保它们保持清洁。
Mm-hmm.
下一问题来自于 Mona Hari。Hari Krishna， 顶拜 Guru 莲花族和所有奉献者，请问 Guru， 我的妈妈喜欢唱歌，现在每天唱诵一会儿 Hari Krishna mantra， 我能送她 Krishna 和 Rama 的照片挂在她家吗？妈妈没有完全食素，感恩 Guru。
Yes, if you want to give her a picture, you can.
是的，你想送她一些照片，你可以。
Even though she's not vegetarian.
即便她现在还没有完全食素。
But still, you can give her a picture of Krishna. Maybe she can become attached to Krishna.
那尽管她还没有完全食素，你仍然可以给她这个照片，也许呢，她就会变得依附于 Krishna 了。下一个问题还是君伟，明白敬爱的 Guru Day。我还有个问题 ，Ekadasi 有三种戒食，相对来说戒食物和水是能被净化的更快一点，是这样理解的吗？感恩 Guru。
You have to understand the purpose of Ekadasi is not just simply fasting. The purpose of Ekadasi is to increase our remembrance of Krishna by more hearing and chanting.
你应该明白，Ekadasi 的目的是什么 ？Ekadasi 的目的呢，不仅仅是戒食，而是为了增加我们能够铭记 Krishna。我们通过聆听和唱诵，能够增加我们对 Krishna 的意念。
So it's not just simply the fasting, which is important, but certainly we don't eat grains and beans.
所以，重要点呢，并不在于戒食。但我们肯定不会吃五谷和豆类。
嗯哼。
问题 Jaya Padma Devadasi Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru 和所有的奉献者感恩您的甜美讲课在国家放歌 2.17 要旨中提到知觉是灵魂存在的证据任何常人均能明白缺了知觉的物质躯体只是一具死尸而已如果没有知觉有可能灵魂还存在吗知觉分精微和粗糙吗知觉等同于灵魂吗感恩您 Hare Krishna
Translate
Yeah So she's asking in Bhagavad Gita Chapter 2 Verse 17 Purport Srila Prabhupada mentioned that consciousness is the proof for the soul that the soul exists and any ordinary people can understand that without consciousness material body is simply a dead body so she's asking is there any possibility that without consciousness the soul still exists
No.
不可能没有知觉灵魂不可能是没有知觉还有灵魂存在
Of course, consciousness can be suppressed, it can be covered. May not be visible in form of life symptoms, just like someone may be unconscious.But the soul is still present, the heart is still beating.
Consciousness can be suppressed, or covered.灵魂它还是存在着的，它的心脏仍然在跳动着。
嗯。
She's continue ask. Can we distinguish the consciousness as subtle consciousness and gross consciousness?
Subtle consciousness.Well, generally we talk about sleeping and deep sleep. And then sleeping, deep sleep, and unconscious.
Usually, we're 这样说的，一个人会处在睡眠状态，深度睡眠状态，失去知觉 ，wakefulness。
Wakefulness, sleeping and deep sleep。
就是人的知觉状态，它是处在清醒、睡眠、深度睡眠状态。
Three different levels of conscious.
这是知觉的不同的层面。She's asking, can we equal consciousness as soul?
No, consciousness is the symptom of the soul.
知觉是灵，知觉就是不能把知觉等同于灵魂。知觉是灵魂的特征。
Because the soul is present, so then there's consciousness in the body.
由于灵魂的存在，所以躯体、身体就有了知觉。下一个问题是来自于阿尼，顶拜 Guru。还想请问 Guru 走在 奉爱修行道路上的奉献者，在离开人世前，是不是应该得到启迪才是最好的？She's asking that guru that for a devotee who's on the path of bhakti, before he or she leave the body, the present body, whether or not should he or she get initiation that is best for him or her?
Well, they have to be qualified for initiation.
他们必须是得有资格，要启迪呢，他们得有资格。
If somebody is not chanting and you initiate them, it doesn't do any good.
倘若一个人他不念诵，然后你要启迪了他，这对他也没有好处。
Initiation is just the ritual, but you have to follow the process. You have to be worthy of initiation.
启迪是一个仪式，你必须要遵守这个方法，必须要配得上，有资格能够得到启迪。
Yeah.
下一个问题来自于 M， 顶拜敬爱的姑娘和奉献者，如何在听消时光能够得到觉悟？每次聆听很费劲，感觉不理解，感恩。Dear Buddha, how can we become realized when we hear the pastimes?Because each time I felt it's very hard for me to understand. I cannot understand it.
Well, you have to hear more.
你应该更多的去聆听。
If you keep hearing, one day you will understand.
倘若你不断的去聆听，迟早有一天就会理解了。
And you have to ask questions. You don't understand? What don't you understand?
您还得问问题。你要是不理解的话，那到底是你哪个地方不理解？有什么地方什么不理解呢？
So you have to raise questions, and then that way you understand better.
所以您要提问题，这样能帮助您更好的去理解。下一个问题还是来自于安妮。你顶拜咕噜和奉献者们，想问咕噜，在医生配的中药中有一味药是蛇粉，和医生说自己吃素了。医生说要治病，要用这个药能吃吗？She's asking that among the Chinese medicines, there is the gradient of the powder of snake. I told doctor that I'm vegetarian, but still the doctor said that to cure the disease,It is a must. So can I eat the medicine?
No.
那就这个药就不能吃了。
We have faith in Krishna, not in medicine.
我们的信心是在 Krishna 身上，我们不是。对于这个药，信心不是在药的身上。
better to die rather than to have, take snake medicine.
倘若必须得吃蛇粉的话，那还不如死了，还不如死掉。
好嘞。
哎呀，下一个问题来自于华为手机。李麦，敬爱的宫殿和奉献者们，昨晚把念诵的珠子放在了夫妻睡觉的房子里了，可以吗？Yeah, Guru Dev, I forgot my Japa Mala in the room where the husband and the wife slept during the night. Is that okay?
Well, you need your Japa Mala the next day.You have to get your japa mala and start chanting. But keep your japa mala with you everywhere. Even you go to sleep at night, take your japa mala, keep it with you near your bed.
因为您需要念珠念诵，所以无论您去哪呢，都要随身带着这念珠。Even in the bedroom?
Yeah.
就是即便是在卧室里也没有关系。下一个问题来自于 Sugita Sangha Devadasi. 顶拜亲爱的 Gurudev, 顶拜 Sugita Sangha.请问 Guru, 如果把 Tusi 净珠免费送给了没食素的人，赠送者会有业报吗？感恩 Guru。 Sugita Sangha Maharaj is asking if we gave Tusi Hunting Mala as a gift to non-devotee, those who are not vegetarian,Will we have the karmic reaction?
Well, they're giving Tosi Mala, is it?
Tanti Mala, Tosi Beads.
For the neck. Well, yeah, we don't want to give these things to people who are meat eaters. It's not recommended.
我们不想把 Tusi 净珠送给肉食者，这种做法是不受到推荐，不被推荐的。
I don't know if you get sinful reactions for doing that, but we definitely want to always avoid sinful reactions.
我不知道。你会不会为此招致罪恶反应？但是我们肯定希望能够避免罪恶反应。
Anyway, you're doing devotional service. Devotional service will always protect you from sinful reactions.
无论如何。您在做着奉献服务，所以奉献服务会始终保护你，免除罪恶的反应。
That doesn't mean that we do sinful things and think we won't get punished.
但是并不意味着，倘若我们犯了罪，做了罪恶活动，就不会被惩罚。
But don't give any more meats to meat eaters.
但是以后不要再给那些肉食者 Tusi 净珠了。
All right.
She's 没食素的人念诵 mantra 可以用念诵 mantra 技术可以用 Tusi 念珠吗？感恩。 she's asking for those who are not yet vegetarian, if they chant mantra, can they use the Tulsi mala?
We prefer not. If they're not vegetarian, we prefer not to give them Tulsi mala.
如果他们是没食素的话，那么我们宁愿不给他们 Tulsi 念珠。
Of course, if they want to go and buy Tulsi themselves, we cannot stop them.
当然，如果他们自己主动去不买 Tulsi 念珠的话，我们是不能够阻止他们的。
Okay.
Okay. 下一个问题来自于君伟。礼拜 Guru Day 和奉献者们，我最近一直引导女儿唱诵 mantra 或女生的 mantra。昨天她用塑料的念珠念了一圈 Hare Krishna， 但她没有念无声体。我怕教她多了，她就不念了。对于孩子不念无声体就念 mantra 有冒犯吗？感恩 Guru Day。
There's no offense.But it's not the recommended way to chant. We first of all approach Lord Chaitanya before we chant Hare Krishna. There's no offense, but they won't get such good result from the chanting because they didn't first of all get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
嗯，这个没有不存在冒犯的问题，但是这并不是被推荐的方法。我们首先要接近主柴丹尼亚，在唱诵哈尔克什纳之前，首先接近主柴丹尼亚。您说的呢，这个没有什么冒犯，但是呢，如果不首先接近主柴，得到主柴丹尼亚仁慈呢，就不会得到很好的结果。
OK，
下一个问题来自于 Prasanta Bigadasi， 顶戴 Guru Day 和所有奉献者。由于我的无知，我把 Tulsi 净珠送给吃肉的人，听了 Guru 的教诲才知道对带净珠的人不好。那怎么跟他解释不让他带，让他摘下来，会不会影响他不接受 Krishna 之觉？深深地明白 Guru。
Well, you already did it. It's okay. Just don't do it again. You can't change people. You gave them already the beads, and you tell them now you can't do it, and they won't listen to you.Anyway, you already did it, so you just have to accept, you know, that it happened somehow.
那么你其实就是你已经送给他了，那就送了吧，只要就是以后就不要再送，不要再这么做了，因为你是无法改变事实的，改变一个人的，他不会听你的，所以你就接受已经发生的事实就好了。
Okay.
Jing Zhu还有妙见飞轮。So she said, except for the Tulsi beads, she also gave the chakra as a gift to people who are meat eater.
Okay, she did it.I mean, I don't think it will be any benefit to them, but anyway.
就是给就给了，但是我说不认为对他们有什么好处。下一个问题是，还是Jaya Padma Devadasi。阿尔克什纳，感恩 Guru 的耐心讲解。我想进一步询问，您说灵魂不等于躯体，但没有知觉，灵魂不等于躯体，但没有知觉，灵魂也不可能存在。没有知觉，灵魂也不可能存在。知觉的不同层面，睡眠、清醒等等，即使是在被覆盖的情况下，知觉依然存在。只是感知不到是吗？从文字来理解，好像 知觉就等于灵魂，感恩您的容忍，期待您的回答，感恩。Thank you, Guru, for your patient explanation. I want to further inquire that you mentioned the soul is not the body, but without consciousness, the soul cannot exist. There are different levels for the consciousness, like sleeping and awakeness. But even in the condition that the soul is covered, the consciousness is still exists. Can I understand that the person simply cannot perceive, right? From the understanding of the words, it seems that consciousness is equal to the soul, equal to soul. Thank you for your patience. I expect to looking forward for your answer. Thank you.
You have to understand the consciousness and the soul cannot be separated, just like sunlight and the sun. You cannot have sunlight without a sun. So the same way, you cannot have consciousness without a soul.
Thank you. 下一个问题是来自于君伟，见了姑姐，不好意思，我还想问一个问题。在把坛里 Daksha 在举行祭祀时，没有邀请 Shiva， 自己的女儿因此将自己的躯体烧毁了。Shiva 在圣怒下杀了 Daksha， 但当 Daksha 的头被换成了山羊的头醒来时，为什么突然之间那种仇恨和嫉妒就没有了呢？就得到净化了呢？那他之前看 Shiva。为什么就没有得到净化？感恩亲爱的 Guru。
Well, you have to understand they're very powerful people, not ordinary people. Daksha committed an offense, so they cut off his head. And then they gave him the head of a goat, and somehow they were able to bring him to life with the head of a goat. Just like sometimes people would die, they could bring them back to life. Sukracharya was a guru of Bali Maharaj, and Bali Maharaj was killed in the battle, but Sukracharya brought him back to life after he'd been killed. So they were very powerful.
首先你要明白，就是说，就是存在着非常有力量的人，他们不是普通人。Daksha 被冒犯了之后呢，头就被切下来，换成山羊的头，但是他就起死复生了。就像有的情况下，就是人能够起死复活 ，Sukracharya 就能把在战场上战死的巴利马拉让他起死复生，他是很有力量的。But her question that previously Daksha had great enemies towards Lord Shiva and hate Lord Shiva, but why suddenly after his head was changed into the head of the goat, that suddenly the hatred and enemies disappeared and Daksha was purified?And she's asking why previously, when Daksha saw Lord Shiva, Daksha was not purified.
Well, when his head was cut off, he was given the head of the goat. It was a very humbling experience. He became humble. He lost his false ego. he realized he was not so powerful as what he thought he was.
就是 Daksha 的头被换成了山羊头，这对 Daksha 来说是一个非常，就是能使他谦卑的一个体验。他就变得谦卑了，他的假自我就没有了。他知道他不像他自以为是的那么有力量。
Okay.
Chaitanya Rupa. 居民小区上的树上花能摘下来供奉吗？ Can we pick the flower from the tree in the compound of the community to offer?
What?
She's asking, we live in a district, there are common trees and flower trees that is for the appreciation of all the residents of the district. So can we pick the flowers from these public trees?
Yes, if you can do it without getting into trouble from the public, if nobody complains.
如果就是大家不给你找麻烦，他们也不抱怨你。
下
一个问题是来自于陈红林。请拜孤儒和所有奉献者，为何如何为长辈做刷的祭祀？陈红林 is asking, how can we do刷的 ceremony for elders in the family?
Well, you have to go to a priest. You have to find a priest who knows how to do it.
您要就是您去得去找那个知道怎么做这个祭祀的祭司。
It's not a ceremony which we often do, but people who are not devotees, they do these things. But devotees, well, people who are engaged in devotional service, they don't do this. They just do devotional service. They just do bhakti.You want to benefit your ancestors, you want to benefit departed souls, just chant Hare Krishna, they'll get a lot of benefit.
This 种仪式呢就是不是经常做的非奉献者就是会去做这些仪式奉献者们他们只做奉爱只从事八体。然后他们就是倘若你要造福你的祖先和逝去的先人的话你就唱 Hare Krishna 这能给他带来大量的好
Okay, how many more questions are there?
One more
Okay, 最后一个问题
好 Yes 最后一个问题 Daman Hare 给 My Guru 的神圣莲花族传教是带业报 Krishna 能把业报带走但是当业报来临很痛苦战胜自己很难现在不是的地步。This is not Christian. Dantari said that, when we preach, there will be some karmic reaction for us. Krishna will take away the karmic reaction, but still it's very painful when the karmic reaction come upon us.So it's very difficult to overcome the karmic reaction. So she's hoping that Gurudev can shelter her.
Okay. We hope so. We'll try. 我们试一试。
Okay, that's all the questions.
Okay, thank you very much. Well, thank Guru Mani, thank all the devotees for their questions. We hope you all have a good week. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Thank you.
Padmamukhi ki jai. Hare Krishna.